how good he is, because he didn't have to come for us. Everything he went through was for us. You know, he being God took the form of a man, was rejected by man all over the place, hated, and hung on a tree that he made. You know, it was for us who hated him. And that's the amazing thing about God's love. He died for those that hated him. You know, and in this life, I've been hated by a lot of people. I'm like, Lord, you loved those that hate you. Hated me. You loved me when I hated you. Help me love them. Yes, help, Lord, help. Yeah. You know, and you got to admit, the gospel is not man's creation. Right? Because if it was man's creation, we would be good. Right? We wouldn't have wrote a book that actually pointed the finger at us. Right? And not to mention, the Jews wouldn't have promoted a Torah that said they were pig-headed and stubborn. You know? But I thank God for his mercy towards us. He realized how much we don't deserve it. You know, and it's amazing because you realize how much you should be thanking God. You don't deserve the next breath. Right, so that next breath is basically a gift. Right? So this is the way you should be living your life. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And everybody looking at you like you're crazy. That's what it is. We don't deserve a next breath, right? And the older I get, I realize that basically the past has nothing for me to grab anymore. I grabbed everything I took from it. Right? It has no virtue. The future is not promised. Right? I could actually walk out and get in a car accident and you never see me again. God forbid, I'm not prophesying to myself. But the truth is, the only thing I have is now. Right? So the important thing is, where are you with Christ now? Right? And your salvation, you can't take for granted. Make sure you're right with Christ now, because tomorrow you can leave. I mean, this week we found the passing of a great man. Billy Graham. Oh, what a man. I mean, such integrity, such passion, such love. You know, and I thank God for his life, you know. But now we in the body of Christ have to realize we have gone on to another stage. The torch has been passed on. Right? You know, Moses, the man of God, has gone and died. Now Joshua, and then I'm now waiting for Joshua to come up and take over. And I'm excited because we're in a new phase. It's not going to be like the old. God's going to be doing things today he didn't do before. Right? And he's going to be doing things that blow our minds away. Just you wait and see. Right? God's going to be using people you never thought he'd be used. And God's going to be getting rid of people you never thought he'd get rid of. Right? We're in a place where the high and mighty are being brought down, and those of lower state are being raised up. Right? And now I am prophesying. Right? Walk my words. You're going to see people used by God in the next year you never heard of. In ways you never imagined. But God's doing something new. And I thank God, because I know what's happening. This is before Messiah comes. And the sign has been all in our faces all the time. Well, the Bible says that Jerusalem will be trodden under the foot of the Gentiles to the time of the Gentiles be fulfilled. When the Jews started coming back to Israel, it was time. That was the sign. That was the sign. And the Jews, the scales fall from their eyes. That's the sign. Right? When the Jews start accepting Christ, it's a sign he's coming. Right? Because the blind, the scales are falling off. They're starting to see the Messiah. Right? And I thank God for what's happening. I want to go home. I'm tired of this world. I'm tired of pain. I'm tired of sorrow. I'm tired of hurt. I want to go home. You know? And that's where my life began. That's where I'm going. Home. And it's going to happen quickly. You know? It's come to the point in my life, this world doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Right. What good is me becoming rich? I have to die and somebody else pays it. Right. Everything you store up within this world, you're going to lose. Right. So I'd rather give it up to gain that which I can't lose. Right. Like Billy Graham, he died, he went to his reward. Right. He's got reward that he'll never lose, and he's going to enjoy it for eternity.
All right? Amen.
And it's worth, because the kingdom of God is worth losing everything over. Everything. Because I see people I'm working with, basically, they're going crazy, getting all this money, working double time, working for Lyft, working for Uber, and they don't have peace. They don't have joy. They don't have hope. They're afraid to die. You know, but in Christ, you have peace, you have joy, you have hope, and there's no need to fear death, because if your heart's right with God, that's just going home. Right? That's why Paul said, if I would stay, it's for your good. If I were for the leave, it'd be for my good. To die is the gain. Be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And he was pondering this. Should I stay to help you guys, or should I go home? You know, what a choice. He had a choice to life here or life eternal. It was funny. Lazarus actually was in the bosom of life. Then Christ, party pooper, Lazarus, come out! And he comes out, and I could have figured out with him, Lord, why'd you call me back? Why'd you do that? Well, you were in the grave for 4 days.
Yes, he did.
And that scared him, because he said he was only going to be in the grave for 3 days. And he just raised somebody for four. Now, that's what terrified the Pharisees. The resurrection of Lazarus scared the daylights out of him, because he said he was only going to come back in 3. And he already went by when Lazarus, he went forward. You know. And I thank God. You know, it's amazing that he would actually take our death, take our shame, take our burden. You know. And the devil had to let him go, because he didn't do anything. He had no sin of his own. He took what he never should have took. You know, and you can actually throw it in the devil's face. That, listen, you don't know everything. Why? Because if you knew what was going on, you wouldn't have took his life. You would have just left him, and he'd still be living. You know, we thank God, because he holds all the cards. He holds all the cards. He holds all the wisdom, the knowledge, and the understanding. And I thank God for what he's doing this day. I feel energized. I feel at peace. I feel a new lease on life.
Yeah.
It comes like, Lord, this is a new day.
Yeah.
These are new things. You know. And I just challenge you to seek the Lord. It doesn't matter what age you are either. It doesn't matter. Right? Abraham was as good as dead when God called him. Right? Moses was used by God into his 120s. Right? And I think it's Moody, or one of the old-time evangelists with all the miracles. He started his ministry at 50. I forgot which one it was. I forgot his name. But his ministry actually started at 50, and he rocked the world. You know, so age is not a barrier to the things God can do. Right? I'm looking forward to seeing what he's doing. I'm looking forward to see little teeny evangelists. Like prince-sized prophets. Right? Sandboxes full of apostles. Because God isn't interested in your education or your rank. He's interested in your heart. And I'm sorry, I came up here to sing and praise God. I seem like I've been preaching. And it looks like I've gone a little over. I'm sorry. It was a half hour, right? Okay, I have to say.
You can do one more song.
Okay, go. One more song. Let's see what we're going to do. Lord, help me. Let me choose.
You don't have to apologize. You did. You did what you did from your heart.
Okay, let's try one of the newer ones. Feed me, Lord, I want man of method. Only your words will fill my soul. Take my cup of feeling living water. On your spirit can calm my thirsting heart. Take my hand. Lead me from above. Guide me in mercy. Lead me in love. In this world of sorrow, I need your peace. This is my strength for tomorrow. In this world of hate, I need your love. This is my strength to always. Take my hand, lead me from above, guide me in mercy, lead me in love. Great in me, clean heart. Restore me all to pure mind. Great in me, clean heart. Restore me all to pure mind. In this world of darkness, I need your light to save me from the foolishness. In this world of weakness, I need your strength to help me walk in your righteousness. Take my hand, lead me from above, guide me in mercy, lead me in love. Create in me a clean heart, restore me all to a pure mind. Create in me a clean heart. Tell me all of your mind. I want your manna from heaven. Feed me all that fresh manna from heaven. Feed me your manna.